In this video, I'm going to teach you how to know if you have an electrolyte deficiency. Hi, I'm Dr. Swarovski from newvisionexcel.com. If you're new to the channel, it's always a pleasure to have you here. Be sure to subscribe, hit that little bell notification, and I'm going to help you excel your health and your life. In this video, we're talking about electrolyte deficiency symptoms. You know, when we look at electrolytes, there's a lot of different symptoms that arise. Now, clinically, there's a lot of questions that we ask to determine if somebody could potentially have an electrolyte deficiency. So we're going to go through these, and I'm going to talk about each and every one of them because, as I mentioned in another video, I've probably had about every symptom there is when it comes to electrolyte deficiencies, because I drove myself into a huge deficit after doing a low carb diet for many years, way before keto was even cool, and also doing strenuous exercise, using intermittent fasting and other forms of fasting as well. Now, a lot of people who follow this channel unknowingly have the same problem, because along with, you know, intermittent fasting and ketogenic diet and exercise, also many people have rapid weight loss, which will cause an electrolyte deficit. So when we look at these electrolytes, they can cause a lot of havoc in our body. So let's go ahead and jump into these different questions that you can ask yourself and determine if this is something that you're facing. The first here is poor muscle endurance. So are you someone who goes to the gym and you feel like no matter how hard you work and how much effort you put in, you just don't have that endurance to, you know, do a lot of reps with your weight or even do any type of long distance cardio because your endurance is so bad? Well, there's a good chance you could have an electrolyte deficiency. This certainly was the case for me. And so definitely keep that in mind. The next thing is muscle cramping. So, you know, whether it's muscle spasms or muscle twitching or muscle cramping, they're all related. So a lot of times you'll get muscle cramping, you're familiar with that. Muscle twitching will typically happen in some smaller muscle groups, like around the eye, around the mouth, maybe in the feet and that sort of thing. But if you're getting any of that, then once again, electrolyte deficiency is probably an issue for you. And this is something that, you know, I'd wake up in the middle of the night with cramps so bad I couldn't even walk them off. And so once again, I can tell you that I've experienced most of these here. Next is frequent thirst. This one's pretty interesting, because how I would explain this is that you feel that you're just very thirsty, you need to drink a lot of water, but then you start drinking your water and you're like, I don't want any water, I've already drank enough. But then you put the water down and then your mind is going, wow, I'm really thirsty. And so, you know, it's a kind of a frustrating thing, but, you know, if you have an electrolyte deficiency, you can feel that way, and you just, no matter what you do, you can't really seem to satiate that thirst. Next here is frequent urination. You know, this one's a pretty interesting one, because I had a very young gentleman in his 20s come to me, and one of his major complaints was just like, man, I'm running to the bathroom all day long, and then all night I'm actually running to the bathroom as well, you know, multiple times. Well, he's young enough that we're not thinking prostate here, but we are thinking, okay, this is someone who's on a ketogenic diet, someone who's doing all the right things and exercising. Well, you know, it turns out he had an electrolyte deficiency. As soon as he balanced that out, he was able to cut his bathroom trips down by probably like 70%. And so frequent urination is a problem here. And you know, these two obviously play into each other, frequent thirst, frequent urination, but the frequent urination is very frustrating for some people. So definitely look to some electrolyte deficiencies there. Next is craving salt. That's pretty self-explanatory. Bowel irregularity, so people who are going from constipated to, you know, IBS symptoms to all over the place, you know, definitely that's something that can be a result of an electrolyte deficiency. Swelling in both the ankles and the wrist, that's an electrolyte deficiency. And the next one is breathing. So we're thinking shallow or rapid breathing. This one's actually a really funny one here. And it, you know, it's one of those things that we just take for granted that we breathe normally on a regular basis. But people who have an electrolyte deficiency, it's almost like they forget how to breathe, or they lose that proper breathing rhythm. So what you'll have is like you'll find yourself taking very shallow breaths, and not like on a consistent basis, but you'll go through kind of like bouts of it. And so very shallow breaths or very rapid breaths, and then you'll start thinking to yourself, wow, what did I forget how to breathe? And then you like focus on breathing in, breathing out, but you don't really know why it's a problem for you. Well, that actually is a problem with an electrolyte deficiency. So, you know, these are all things that really disrupt your life in a big way. I mean, I even had personally a problem with high blood pressure, where the longer I fasted, my blood pressure would continue to creep up. So once again, that was related to electrolytes. And so all these different symptoms right here can be a major problem if you put yourself in a huge electrolyte deficit. And let me tell you, you feel awful. Exercise feels awful. Everything feels awful with an electrolyte deficiency. So how do you bring them back up? So first of all, you can take a multivitamin that has these different electrolytes in them, which is powerful, right? For me, that wasn't enough. The other thing that you can do is you can actually increase your amount of sea salt consumption, which has good electrolytes in it. For me, that also was not enough. And I couldn't consume enough salt to actually hit the levels that I needed. You know, at the time I was, you know, using pickle juice, that was recommended. You know, that's kind of an athlete trick. Well, if you do any type of endurance stuff, pickle juice, but actually research proves to us now that pickle juice is totally ineffective. So what I do is I actually supplement with it. I take a powder. I'll go ahead and link the one that I use in the description below. It's an electrolyte powder / energy drink, and I use it as a pre-workout, but I also use it throughout the day to give me a boost and also mostly boost up my electrolyte levels, because I can tell you, taking a multivitamin and also eating a lot of sea salt and using some of these different methods, like even cream of tartar that has that's high in potassium, that was not nearly enough for me doing endurance training. And so, and following the ketogenic diet and all these other things. So anyway, I have to supplement with it. Many people should be supplementing with it, even though they're not, because they would feel so much better. I did another video on electrolyte deficiency in one meal a day, because that's something that people who are fasting or doing intermittent fasting have a problem with. If you want to check that video out, go ahead right here. I just list a bunch more different symptoms that people face. Other than that, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. Share it with your friends, because if they have an electrolyte deficiency, I can guarantee you they feel awful. You just can't feel good with it. And then other than that, subscribe to my channel. Check out my other videos over here on intermittent fasting and ketosis, and then I'll see you in the next video.